This particular project has been in the making for many, many years. It's been almost a three-way project in the sense that we have the V&A, a private collector, contributing some amazing works for this project, and John Jones as a solution finder. Several of the works have been framed beautifully in several stages over the years, and they're part of a private collection. The artworks that have been loaned to this exhibition have been unframed. The V&A are framing several of the works. We're framing them with the V&A for the show. The project is broken down into categories, eras, places of horse photography. And when you walk through the exhibition, if you really look carefully, you'll see that there's a slight identity change through each section. But on the whole framing project has a pulse, it works together. We've worked with wood. We've worked with paint wash finish and stain wash finishes on wood. We've worked with bespoke gesso frames. We've also included an element of gilding to the bespoke gesso frames. And we've worked with brazed brass with a chemical application. All flow very well together. When we have an opportunity to be involved in such a prestigious, visually amazing exhibition, I think as picture framers, as designers, we have a responsibility to make sure that we're doing something new that works. Something with respect to the photographer and perhaps a style that the photographer would have liked to use, using colour tones and the right materials. When you're familiar with how that process works and when something is right and when you can share it with a team of 60, 70, 120 individuals, when you could recognise that this is something that's worked really well, that's where the magic starts to happen. There are differences between frame makers. And as a picture framer, I think what we have in common with the other picture framers is that we join four corners together. The main difference is that we use materials that are the best, the most researched materials. Understanding glazing technology is key. Understanding how to explain the prices and the values of these materials over a long period of time. Being able to unearth what's actually wrong, what's actually right, what needs to be done with a piece of work, that can be quite a gritty process, but bringing the client, the collector into that process is a fascinating, fascinating place to be. There's a great deal of learning involved in picture framing. I think the majority of my time in a one-to-one consultation these days, certainly half of the meeting will be based on understanding the preservation aspect of the work, what it needs to go through in order to be preserved best for the long time. What should the collector expect to see, regardless of how the frame's going to look? What should the artwork look like when it's completed? Then when it comes to the frame design, it's like kids in sweet shops here, we can do whatever we like. Understanding how metal works with wood, how wood works with plastic, how different tones and gilding, how we can encompass all of these amazing aspects, we have the freedom to do so. It was essential that not only myself and my colleagues in the design studio understood what it was we were trying to achieve, that there are over 100 individuals in the business who also needed to understand what we were going to achieve with this project. There are incredibly specialist finishes working with gesso and the waxing of gesso, gilding and the handling of brass, that everyone involved in that project needed to understand what the outcome was going to be. It's a massive, massive commitment from the collector, from the museum, from John Jones to be involved in such a visually amazing project. With the Horse P Horse project, we worked so closely with various people at the beginning of the project. I think it was essential at the early stages to make sure we were really on the same path with the understanding of what it was going to look like. Seeing the outcome before deadline is an amazing, amazing position to be in, and especially when the outcome exceeds what we all expected it to look like. We knew it was going to work, but the finish is just better. Really thrilled and excited to see how it's going to look, how the public are going to react to it.
All the years of seeing photographic shows, I have never in my life seen tribute paid so perfectly to the artist's work. Framing doesn't overwhelm what you came to look at.